Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Redstone video. Today I'm here with T2 Studios to show you how to build this fully customizable item shop we designed together. Introduce yourself.
Hello everybody, I'm T2 and I also create Redstone videos on my channel.
You heard him. So if you're looking for some more quality Redstone content, go check out his channel and subscribe. Anyways, back to the item shop. It allows you to set the type and amount of payment and payout items, from 1 to 1, all the way up to 63 to 320. While payment items have to be stackable, the payout can be anything, even a combination of different items. Only the currency set by the shop owner gets accepted, and the product is deposited into the same barrel that you also pay into.
The shop features a smart auto-locking mechanism that prevents customers from paying when they should not be able to, such as while the system is still resetting. This essentially means that you can input multiple payments at once and they'll all get individually processed. The auto-lock also activates when the system runs out of stock, which is indicated by this lamp in the front. That way, you can't pay when there's nothing to pay for.
Let's quickly go over how it works. If you want to jump straight to the tutorial instead, you can just skip to about 4 minutes in this video. Oh, and one more thing, if you're looking for a slightly more compact version of this shop, which sadly however isn't quite as customizable, you should definitely also check out Crafty Masterman's latest video. A link to that one can also be found in the description.
Let's start with what happens when a player inputs their payment. If we look inside this hopper, you'll see that we have some shovels and a bit of our payment item. These make up our typical item filter. Because the shovels are non-stackable, only gold in this case will be able to enter the hopper, that's why anything else just stays in the barrel. The amount of payment items here is important too, because as soon as it reaches a full stack of 64, it will activate this comparator which sets off the rest of the system. The way we set the correct amount of items for the payment and payout is by using these two hopper clocks. These work by passing a certain amount of items from one hopper to the other, and at the same time shifting this redstone block from one piston to the other. In the top hopper clock, the redstone block shifts past the hopper under the payout stock barrel, unlocking it for the same amount of time as it takes all of the items to move to the other side of the hopper clock. That way, the amount of payout that gets deposited into the barrel is the same as the amount of items in the hopper clock. The same exact thing happens with the bottom hopper clock, but this one lets a certain amount of the payment item out of the item sorter, so you have to pay the same amount again next time, effectively resetting the system. The problem with using hopper clocks is that you always have to wait for the items inside to flow back to the first hopper before they can get activated again. This redstone line will activate whenever there are any items in the far hopper of either of the clocks, preventing anything from being pulled from the barrel. This auto-lock system also activates when the shop runs out of stock via this redstone torch.
For this build, you will need an area that is at least 3 blocks wide, 6 blocks tall and 7 blocks deep, and your wall needs to be at least 3 blocks wide and 2 blocks tall. First off, take out these two leftmost wall blocks right here, place a barrel in this spot with a redstone lamp on top, and that will be your user interface. Now place a temporary block below this center wall block, with another barrel below it, take out the block, and now just place a comparator on top of the barrel going to the right side. Place hoppers going into the comparator and into the barrel, like this, a block to the right of the barrel, and two more blocks at the back of it. Now place redstone dust on top of this block, a repeater going into the side of the comparator, and another comparator going into the repeater. And at the back of that one, just place another barrel like this. Next to this bit of redstone dust right here, you now want to place a target block like this, so that you can see this redstone dust going into the target, with a node block next to it, then an observer coming out of the node block, going towards the back of the machine, into a block, with an upwards pointing regular piston next to the block. Now just place another observer right here on top of that barrel, going towards the front of the machine, into a block, with redstone dust on top, and now just also place redstone dust on top of the observer. Back on top of this block right here, you now want to place a temporary block with a hopper going into it from the front. Take out the block again and just place another hopper going back into this first hopper. So now you should see these two hoppers facing each other. Place a comparator on top of this node block coming out of this first hopper, going into a block with redstone dust on top, a sticky piston in this spot pointing towards the back with a redstone block at its face, and now just place another block right here. Once again a comparator coming out of the hopper, going into a block with redstone dust on top, and then a regular piston going towards the front of the machine. Now let's just do the same exact thing again, but a few blocks lower, so come down two blocks from this block right there. Once again place a hopper going into that block, take out these two blocks, and place a hopper going back into that one, so that once again these two face each other. Place a block right here, a comparator on top of that one, going into a block with redstone dust on top, a sticky piston in this spot, going towards the back with a redstone block at its face, and now just once again place a block right here, comparator on top coming out of the hopper, going into a block, and now just place another block diagonal to that, like this. Place redstone dust on top of this block, and just a regular piston, yeah, in this position, once again going towards the front. Back on the other side, next to this hopper right here, you now want to place a block with redstone dust on top of it. Place another block next to this one, with a repeater on top, coming out of this block, going into another block, with redstone dust right here, and another block below this hopper. At the back of the machine, you now want to place a block down here, with redstone dust on top. And if you don't want the machine to, yeah, play a sound when a purchase is made, you can just place a block right here. But if you, yeah, basically want to have a confirmation sound every time someone purchases something, I'd suggest placing an emerald block right here with a node block on top, and now just clicking this node block 19 times. Place a block right here with a repeater coming out of the node block, going into a block, another block diagonal to that, one next to that one, and then a half slab. And now just place 4 bits of redstone dust on top of all these blocks. Place 2 blocks like this, adds another one on top of this repeater, with a repeater coming out of this block up here, going into two more bits of redstone dust. Going into this barrel right here, you now want to place two hoppers like this, with another barrel on top of this last one. Now place a comparator coming out of the barrel going into the redstone lab, and just three blocks like so. So one right here, one right here, and another one in this spot, with a comparator coming out of this block and going into this one, which has a redstone torch at its back. If you want, you can now also place in two item frames at the front, one of them for the payment and one of them for the payout item. In which way you order these, it's up to you. If you want, you can also now add some more additional storage. If you feel like this one barrel isn't enough for you, you can just add another one down here with a hopper, or just link this up to any kind of central storage system.
Now I'm going to show you how to program the shop for your specific needs. We're going to start with the hopper clocks. This is super simple because you just need to put the same amount of items in the hoppers as you want to have the player pay and receive. The bottom clock will be for your payment amount and the top one for your payout amount. Next, we're going to set up the item filter. First, you need to find this barrel and put 24 non-stackable items inside. This will ensure that the item filter only activates the rest of the system when it is completely full. For the filter itself, put a stack of your payment item in the first slot of this hopper and fill the rest with more non-stackable items. You should see that the system automatically activates and calibrates the hopper to have the correct amount of items for the next payment. The barrel above this hopper will be where your customers interact with the shop. They will both pay and receive their items here. This top barrel is where you will place your stock. You can also expand the storage by using hoppers if needed. Next, you'll want to put another set of your payout amount into the buffer hopper below to make sure customers always receive the correct amount of items, even as the shop runs out of stock. Finally, you can collect your earnings in this bottom barrel. Once again, the storage is also expandable.
Let's just quickly go over an example. So, in my case, I want to sell 16 enderpearls for the price of 5 gold ingots. So, because I want customers to pay 5 items, I now just put 5 items into this lower hopper right here. And because I want them to receive 16 items, I just put 16 items into this upper hopper. Next up, let's just open up this barrel right here, and into it we now want to put 24 non-stackable items, like this. Open up the hopper below the payment barrel, and into that one you first want to put 64 of your payment item, so in my case gold, into the first slot, and then just fill the rest of these slots with non-stackable items. Now let's just set up our payout. So first off, open the stock barrel and just put your stock inside it. You should now see this lamp lighting up. And now open the buffer hopper and just put whatever you're setting into that one. So because I'm setting 16 enderpearls, I just put 16 enderpearls into this one, into the hopper. But if you would be selling, let's just say 32 carrots, you would now put 32 carrots into this hopper instead. Okay, and that should already be everything, fully working. Let's just test it out. So let's put some gold ingots in here. As you can see, 5 gold ingots got removed from this stack, and I got 16 enderpearls in return. And after the system has reset, it should take out another 5 and give me another 16 enderpearls. And because the system is now out of stock, it doesn't take away any more gold ingots. As you can see, it has taken away half of the buffer, because I only put in 16 and a half or like 1.5 stacks of enderpearls, but I was setting one stack, so the buffer is just there in order to make sure no users get scammed when the system runs out of stock. Okay, let's just go over how you can change the amount of payment and payout items. So for that, just activate this, these two regular pistons right here. And now you can just access these two hoppers and change the amount of items inside them. And once you're ready, just take out the redstone blocks again. And after your next purchase, it should already be changed. And that's already it. Thank you so much for watching, everyone.
This whole process, from designing the contraption to making the video, was a blast, and we hope you had as much fun as we did.
Once again, definitely check out T2's channel. All this wouldn't have been possible without him. We'll see you next time. Bye.
See ya.